4 o'clock.
Welcome back to VITA Social News, 4 o'clock German time here in Bad Säcking. So yeah, you had to mood it, man.
I did.
Is my Italian friend, Bini, Emi Bini, or you remember maybe Jack Nicholson from the 50s. I took him back to now.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us. I'm here with Michael. Everybody knows Michael.
No, I don't think so.
Not everyone.
Yeah.
But a lot of you know Michael. And we are here today to talk about
VITA ENAMIC and VITA AKZENT LC, a new product. I think some of you will never heard about it, but I will talk about it.
We did mention it a couple of times, I think.
I think so too, but last month. Maybe some of them.
Indeed, indeed.
So go downstairs.
I'll go downstairs.
No, just kidding you. So we will talk about VITA ENAMIC. Come, Amy, come here. So VITA ENAMIC is our topic, and just I will give you a small history about the product when we did invent this. R&D, research and development. It is rhythm and dance, actually.
Rhythm and dance, R&D. Makes sense. So I'm just going to move out of the way so that our viewers can watch the beautiful presentation, but I'm here.
So when we did start to invent the product, we were looking on things we do since many, many years in our environment and also what the nature is doing. So I was talking about the sea urchin, the spin of the sea urchin. It is actually a network with, interpenetrating network, this sea urchin spin. And also what we do since many, many years in the building, we are using a method with steel and concrete. So we put both things together. We have the steel and we have the concrete. One is for the compressive strength and one is for the tensile strength. So this is the thing we do since many, many years. And with this option, it is possible to build houses 200 or 250 or even 300 meters high. Okay? And this is the exact method we do with VITA ENAMIC. We are using a network out of ceramic because ceramic has no deformation before it cracks. And we put inside a material like a plastic, we all know, we are all using every day, which is possible to tear up to 90% longer, and then it's coming back, or it will not break. So two completely different materials are combined.
You mentioned before the building concepts, and this is actually what happens in earthquake areas.
Yeah.
So that the building will not collapse. But
exactly. Yeah, it will not collapse. It will like rhythm and dance. So we are back.
R&D.
The rhythm. Yeah, R&D. So yeah, the buildings will not collapse. They will move a little bit. Okay, if it's too heavy, such earthquake, it will collapse. Yeah,
of course.
That's unfortunately not completely possible. Yeah. So, but we put both things together. Like here in the production, I think the pictures of the productions are showing this. We mix the ceramic already with the metal oxides in. So the metal oxides, the pigments are in the ceramic already in. So we do not color the plastic. We are not coloring the polymer, the infiltrating polymer. So this is the main thing. This is the one of the biggest advantages in focusing, discoloring and things like this, because the color is already in the porcelain, in the ceramic. Then we press it here in this pressing, you see, we press it in blocks, and then we are sintering this block. Here, my friend, he is one of our masters of firing or sintering, and he will stop the sintering process at a certain stage. So it looks like this. So the pressed material, pressed ceramic or porcelain powder, and then the sintered porcelain, the sintered ceramic. This looks under the SEM like this. So lots of sinter necks. And my friend Enno Boyemüller, he's always saying you can start on the left corner and run through it without falling into one hole, because we have the sinter necks, they're all sticking together. And this is the main difference to all composite materials. This is the main difference. We have sinter necks, it will stick together. And if you are firing the enamic block, you will have a stable product, a stable ceramic. Of course, with holes, like you can see here, but just with holes. It will not flow away, run away. And then the magic is coming. Then the magic is coming. The magic is coming. Amy will stay there. His hand will be fired.
Not too long.
Not too long. And we will take this stable material, and will infiltrate the polymer. And the polymer will be sucked into the holes and will be completely dense into the material. And this is our biggest secret here.
Question to you. Is this why we consider enamic being a hybrid material?
Exactly.
Okay, so is it fair to say that enamic is the true only hybrid material?
In my opinion, yes, absolutely. I will show you some properties that makes it even more clear. I think that makes it even more clear that it is completely different to any other material which is named nanoceramic, which is named hybrid ceramic, which is named composite. So it will be, after the talk, I think everybody will be clear that it is a completely different material to all others available on the market. And afterwards, there is the polymerization, which is with heat and pressure. So all together, and you can find this in our technical scientific documentation, you will find also this. It is a feldspar-based ceramic, close to the VitaBlocks material, which is proven and used since 35 years. Can you think about this? Mm-hmm. Since 35 years. And it's this, and a UDMA and TEC-DMA color, without color, transparent mixture of the polymer. So this is transparent. The color is already in the ceramic, and it is one of the main questions on the market: is it color stable? And there are lots of study. I just focus on one study by the University of Boston. Russell Giordano was doing this testing, and he was comparing Mark II VITA ENAMIC composite resin and acrylic into water, coffee, UV, thermo, and thermo coffee, and then looking on all the things, on all the color points, and he found out that enamic is as color stable as the VITA blocks material, as a pure ceramic, just like a pure feldspar.
Wow.
And all others, composite resin, acrylics, they have a non-color stable material. And enamic, it is color stable. The color is already in the ceramic, and nothing will happen to the ceramic. But still, on the market, there is lots of discussions. Is it a composite? Is it a hybrid? And for sure, from the Latin word, mm-hmm. you are Italian, you know, Latin word, componere, mm-hmm. composition, to two things together.
Build up together, yeah. Yes.
Of course, but in dental area, the word composite is used for different things. And if you do not know something, you are asking Wikipedia. I do this. I think lots of people are doing this.
I prefer Google.
You prefer Google, but yes. Then you will have the same answer, I think. According to Wikipedia, composites are used in dentistry or dental technique. Are tooth-colored plastic materials for dental treatments. They consist of an organic plastic matrix which is mixed with inorganic filler particles. And there is no filler particle. We have a network, so that's the difference. We have a network out of ceramic and not a filler particle. We infiltrate polymer into a ceramic network.
Not and the have other way around.
Exactly, and we do have an inner penetrating network material, network network material. So this it's completely different to
and unique,
a field.
I think, yeah?
It is absolutely unique. And what is the main thing? What is the main thing for a dentist? The main thing, if you have a material which says it is a ceramic, you start to etch it. Of course, that's the workflow when you etch and bond, etch and bond, etch and bond. So with ceramics, you are etching and then bonding to the teeth. And if you do this with a filled material, so filler particles, of course, you will etch some areas, some filler areas, but you will not etch the whole surface. And that's a huge difference. So you will not etch the complete surface, you will etch some of the particles. Of course, you will etch them, but it will not stay in the mouth. It will not be bonded perfectly to the tooth. That's why you need another method for composites. You need to sandblast the surface. And also sandblasting, it's not so easy like it sounds. There is a study by Rosentritt and Baer from the University of Regensburg. And if you do this not properly, you will have maybe some cracks coming from the sandblasting, which will cause a damage during the wear. And this can also bring problems because they will have a debonding or also some cracks in the materials during the wear.
So this is also important that we follow the recommendations.
Exactly.
Of, you know.
You have to follow the recommendations, but also sandblasting, it's not so easy for a dentist because not a lot of dentists are having, a really good sandblasting.
Okay.
Dental technicians, sure, they all have sandblasting. They need the sandblasting for de-vesting, for the pressing,
and.
So sandblasting, dental technician, yes, dentist, do not have, everyone is not having such a good sandblasting device.
Okay.
And the sandblasting, as I mentioned, is not so easy. But if you have enamic, you can etch the surface. And this is how the etched surface is looking like. So just as etching, silanization and bonding. That's the main and known workflow for any ceramic material. You can do the same workflow as with your glass ceramic, as with your feldspar ceramic, and. So that is, I think, very simple, and everybody is doing this since up to 35 years. And there is also a study about the bonding. There, it's a study from the university in Hong Kong, Dr. Tian Tian. She was comparing glass ceramics, so Emax CAD, VITA Suprinity, to the bonding of VITA Enamic. And you see here some different bonding systems, Clearfill SA, for Nexus from Care, VITA Duo Cement, Variolink from Ivoclar, 3M SB, Relay X Ultimate, and all over, they had more or less the same results. With some bonding agents, it was the best result with VITA Enamic, some had a better one with the Emax CAD, but all over, we see that the bonding is more or less the same when you do the etch and bond with VITA Enamic. So another thing, I think, important thing, also comparing to composites, it's the abrasion during the wear. So we are doing here a toothbrush abrasion test. So we have samples, we are brushing them 32 hours. So really brushing, brushing.
It's a long time.
It's a very long time. So, and then we are comparing the results. And we see here in this toothbrush abrasion test, VITA Enamic is also acting here like Mark II, like a feldspathic material. It has a different result as, in this case, Paradigm or 3M SB Lava Ultimate. And how is it looking like under the SEM when we look on this We have here the Lava Ultimate, the Shofu HC, which is also named a nano ceramic, hybrid ceramic. But you see a clear difference to VITA blocks and VITA Enamic, which have a smooth surface and not the, the lines from the toothbrush. This is a huge difference. And as my last property slide, I think it's the last property slide, we have different materials. We have Inceram alumina, and this is nearly gone on the market. We have zirconia, we have Emex Cat or glass ceramic, we have porcelain, and we have Mark II as a feldspathic-based silicate ceramic. And we see here, just focusing on the E-modulus, that there are over 50 gigapascal. When we look now on the tooth, on the tooth structure, the dentin and enamel is different. So enamel is over 50, so they are all playing, just focusing on the E-modulus in the area of the enamel, but the dentin is around about 20 gigapascal. Okay? And what is the thing? We did put enamic, and this can be done with some different steps of the porosity of the ceramic. We put it just between the dentin and the enamel. Why? To simulate the tooth as good as possible. Mm-hmm. To simulate the tooth as good as possible. And I think this is very, very good for every one of us. This is very, very good for every one of us, because this product will simulate the tooth as close as possible. We can etch and bond, so the normal workflow as with ceramics. We have the abrasion like a normal tooth, and also the elasticity of a tooth. So I think that's...
This is what I wanted to say, because it's very close to natural dentition.
Exactly.
So it should not put too much strain on, maybe for the implants,
Exactly.
On the tendons and
muscles.
Yeah,
exactly.
Okay.
It's perfect. Then when we mill the product, we can stain it. And this is, I mentioned this already, we have a new staining product. We have the AKZENT LC. This is new since IDS 2021. We were showing this in Cologne. And it is light curing, that's why LC, light curing material. You can use it on all CAD-CAM hybrid nano ceramics composites, on all of them. You can use it on your veneering composites you are using. You can use it for the denture teeth, and you can use it also for the base.
So Michael, sorry to interrupt you. Before we go a little bit deeper on the AKZENT, we got people from all over the world watching us. You know, we got Thailand, Syria, Egypt, okay. France, Sweden, etc., etc. And we got a couple of questions.
Okay,
one
sorry.
Is from our friend Venser.
Oh, Venser. Hi, Venser.
Ciao, Doc. He's asking, what is the effect of brushing with enamic stains?
With the enamic stains?
Yes.
The enamic stains, look. The enamic stains are on the surface. You apply the enamic stains, like you are etching slightly the surface, so you penetrate the surface a bit with the stains, but they are still just on, a little bit inside the material, but on the surface, and with the brushing, it will be not as stable. That's why actually we did invent also this product, because this is more stable than the enamic stains. Yeah. But with the infiltration, the slight infiltration, we are etching the surface, then we put the stains on top.
Okay.
We have it a little bit deeper, and that this is more stable than comparing to other other materials.
And well, thank you on behalf of Dr. Venter. we have another one. Can we tell the difference between this is for you too. This one?
Ah, so solid.
Yeah, HT. Solid HT white, HTPS, FX, FXPS.
But the solid is, as far as I know, is a zirconia.
Eh.
The zirconia is a completely different material. Zirconia, for sure, it's a good material, but it's a completely different material. Enamic.
And workflow, too.
Workflow is also different. You have to sinter it, you cannot just polish it. It's completely different, yeah. So I think we should address this topic on another day. Then I will talk about zirconia, if you like. And the workflow with zirconia, and also the things you have to address and think about with the zirconia. But it is a completely different material, and I, in my opinion, also for a different indication. I would use this material, the VITA ENAMIC, for single tooth restorations, inlays, thin veneers. I will show you some cases, maybe then you will understand for what indication I would use ENAMIC, and also for other indications I would go for zirconia. Yeah.
But back to you, we will keep your question and address it next time talk about the zirconia.
Okay.
Cool. Yeah, that was easy.
So yeah, we invented a new glazing staining material. Why? Because the VITA ENAMIC stains weren't as good as we hoped. Brushing and things like this. Of course, if you have something on the surface, if you use a very abrasive tooth paste and not the soft
it's gonna wear the restoration.
It will wear, of course. There will be a wear. Not with the zirconia, but with all other materials over the time, there will be wear.
And not with zirconia, because zirconia is so strong that
nothing will happen.
Coconuts, yeah. And so you'll this be fine.
Coconuts, maybe you should not eat coconuts and open the bottle with zirconia as well.
No.
But yeah, you can use it everywhere. What do you need? You need a lamp between 350 and 500 nanometer wavelength. I think most of the devices are possible to use for this. We are using here from UltraDent the Halo, but I think there are lots of different ones available, and in the dental laboratories it's even better. We have there also temperature and a very good light, so it will be even faster than with a lamp on the dental chair. But both is working. You just need emission spectrum from 350 to 500 nanometer. Then everything is working. What do we have in colors, in possibilities? We have effect stains, like we all know from the VITA AKZENT Plus. Mm-hmm. So if some of you are using the AKZENT Plus for VITA blocks and things like this, it is the same colors. We have the same chroma stains, so the classical 3D master ones, and the glazing material. I think this is very easy to understand. This is the bottle. The bottle is looking like this. It is the triangle, and also here, like we introduced with the Lumex system, it's color-coded. So if you have this in your drawer, it's easy.
It's easy to identify easy. What
yeah.
you need, yeah?
Yeah, you can put this again on your eyes.
Like this.
So I can directly see it's blue, and blue means enamel area. So the effect stains, it's here blue. Or enamel, effect enamel with a VITA Lumex, it's blue. So you will understand this and see this. And what you can also see here, we have here russet, we have pink and dark red. This is a reddish or a red staining material, and red you can use also for sure. You can use for the denture base. So even you can put your denture base on a higher level just by painting it, and then you do the light curing, and then you can over polish it. It looks fantastic.
I'm going to ask possibly a silly question, but then again, I'm not a technician, so please bear with me. When it's light cured, it's obviously, I think, faster than when it's heat cured, when you have
yeah,
to
yeah,
burn
yeah.
a furnace. Okay. That
it
was
is
just
faster,
for my personal...
Much faster than staining in a dental furnace, of course, much faster.
The first...
2 to 3 minutes, and it's
okay, and done.
Done.
Okay.
And for the dental technicians, furnaces, light furnaces, mm-hmm. I don't know, actually, light furnaces, yeah, I think.
Yeah, maybe.
Light chamber, for them, it's about 3 minutes. Wow. That's it. So, okay. And you can directly use it because it's still cold. You can touch it and not like from the furnace when it's coming out, it's 500-600 degrees and you have to leave it there. This is much faster and the colors are the same. We have two kits. We have two kits, a standard kit. We say standard kit because these are, we think, the most used colors. Mm-hmm. And the expert kits with all of them. So whatever you like, you can do it there. So I will just now, I think we have time. I think we have time. I will show you some cases. I have some cases, not the normal one cases, but where can we use VITA ENAMIC as well? Mm-hmm. I think this is, to me, it's one of the most interesting uses of VITA ENAMIC.
Can we say uses? Yes, of course.
Yeah,
I think so. You can say whatever you like. I mean.
Ah, so okay. Yeah. This is my friend Polina Kotlarenko. She is a dentist at the University of Vienna, and she is there the head of a special ambulance. This special ambulance is a place where people are going with less enamel or bulimia or things like this. Mm-hmm. So normally young girls and young boys, actually. Mm-hmm. Also with some depressions and things like this. And then she will send them first to the psychologist mm-hmm. to get this done.
Fixed. And then you need to
and
fix
then
these.
She's fixing the teeth. And here we have a young girl. She has amelogenesis imperfecta. So her enamel is not perfect. And then I will show you the workflow, how Polina is helping her. In this case, so she's first starting with the initial situation. So here's the initial situation, and then she's starting to elevate the bite, but in small steps, because these patients are not happy with their situations, and she cannot be very fast with them, because it's still a mind and depression and things like this. And then she's elevating the bite. She's using for this from Armand Gebach, the Sera Mill Motion System.
I see.
With a virtual articulator. So she's doing this, and then she is using always VITA ENAMIC. And it's quite interesting, she is using the monochromatic VITA ENAMIC in this case, and not the multi-chromatic, mm-hmm. the multi-layer VITA ENAMIC, because she's not really preparing the teeth. She's using the own teeth of the patients, because they are normally not discolored or things like this, mm-hmm. and not really preparing them, because they have already some defects in the teeth, mm-hmm. like the
wear and tear.
Wear, tear, the stomach.
Exactly. That's what, you know, with
exactly. Bulimia situation is happening. So she's not touching the teeth she's touching the teeth as less as possible.
Well, it seems that they're already being prepped.
Yeah, exactly. This patient has no enamel,
yes.
or not real enamel. So she's not touching them more or hurting the teeth more. And then she's designing the ENAMIC. Why ENAMIC? She's using ENAMIC. Why? Because you can mill it so precise, so thin, that you do not need to touch the teeth more.
0.2
in the preparation area.
Yes.
So she doesn't need to prep the teeth, or she can let them as small as or as thick as possible.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And that's why she's using ENAMIC. And you see here the result from the beginning to the end. I think it is fantastic, and the girl can live with this.
Yeah, the before and after.
Yeah, before and after. I show you again here. I have here before and after, before.
Definitely.
And after. Now she's happy again, and she's healthy again. also here she's healthy, and I think this is
build very the confidence and everything on in her smile.
Have another case from Michael Zauer. I think I showed him many times. Also, no preparation or nearly no preparation, just designing with the software and then the milling. And this is in the Zahnfabrik system. It's in the Zahnfabrik system. Even the Zahnfabrik system can mill such thin parts.
And you can do it also with the, I think there's a program with the schnell, the
fast milling.
The fast milling.
Yeah.
Under 5 minutes you can do it. So it's really.
Exactly. 5 minutes.
One appointment crown. See
exactly.
You later. So while, you know,
exactly.
When we speak, you mill.
Exactly.
Etch, you bond.
Exactly. And this is how it looks like.
Contact lens.
Etch and bond, contact lenses. And this is the result.
Wow.
Yeah.
Amazing.
It is amazing. So. We will talk next time about zirconia. I think we should talk about zirconia. There was a question regarding the zirconia. Are there some questions more?
Or there's just a few comments from our friend Noor Dashan. He says hello. Emad is online, so Australia and Argentina have joined us as well.
Cool.
And Dr. Venter again, he says that 0.3 occlusal onlay, thinnest I have done. He was blown away with the enamic. And this is great Venter. Result, Venter, and I'm sure you can push it to 0.2.
I think we should get Venter here in a VMAX call, so we can talk with him directly.
Venter, I'll engage with you, and we'll do this, and we'll talk with you directly next time if you're available.
Next week is zirconia. We promised it already. So in 2 weeks' time, we will talk with Venter. In 2 weeks' time, we will talk with Venter.
That leaves me more time to organize the call.
Exactly. So if you have questions, please write here in the comments or email to info@vita-zahnfabrik.com or for Emad that he will also understand this info@vita-zahnfabrik.com
or as Venter suggested dash
for info@vita-zahnfabrik.com. We will be happy to help you, and if you would like to have addressed here a topic like the one here asking for zirconia materials, just let us know. We are here for you.
Indeed.
We are here for you. And if you have such topics, we will be happy to help you and to address such a topic. Wish you a good evening or a good day or, yeah.
Or a good night.
A good night. Yeah, in some cases, I think Emad will start to sleep just now. It's 12 o'clock there, isn't it?
Yeah, it should be.
Yeah.
It should be.
Emad. Go to bed.
Go to bed. Thank you, everyone, for being with us. See you next week.
See you next week. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Das war gut.